is Muhammad Firdaus bin Baharum, matrix number 20209092 75. Today I would like to present about oil pump. Oil palm, or Elais genesis, is a tropical tree crop which is fundamentally developed for its modern creation of vegetative oil. It is a commonplace bouquet crop developed and gathered over huge uniform zones around a focal oil factory to permit fast modern taking care of subsequent to collecting. Palm tree can likewise be seen in town gardens where they give oil to nearby utilization. However, all things considered, both yield and oil quality are a lot of low. Oil palm is a commonplace yield of the stormy tropical swamps. The tree requires a profound soil, a moderately steady high temperature and non-stop dampness. Consistently, soil fruitfulness is less significant than actual soil properties. Dry times of more than 2 or 3 months don't explicitly harm vegetative development. However, influence genuinely the creation and nature of the organic product packs. Oil palm yield isn't just dictated by vegetative development and creation, yet additionally, accidentally, and vermin infection can be controlled or annihilated. Getting the right amount of nutrients in manuring process is one of the effective manuring in agricultural practices. There are a few steps for manuring in oil palm. First, need to know the block size. This step is to confirm the manuring block are synchronized in terms of soil type, terrain, palm size, and palm age. This is important to know the nutrient needed and the quantity. This step also important before move to another step. After do some research on manuring block size and get the accurate information. Many information we can get from the first step. After getting the data, record the data and keep it tight. From the data collected, we manage to get many information. After that, we can design strategies to reduce nutrient losses. To avoid the nutrient loss, we must do a strategy on manuring. First, the fertilizer chosen. Common fertilizer in oil palm is urea and NPK compound fertilizer. Compound fertilizer must apply as usual and follow the schedule created. NPK compound fertilizer has their own weightage on amount of nutrient. Next is apply direct fertilizer. Direct fertilizer means apply only one nutrient on manuring. Manuring in oil palm has the placement on putting the fertilizer. For the matured plant, apply the fertilizer at the front arrangement and the young plant around the canopy of the plant. This is because the root of the oil palm grow as the canopy of the plant. There are a few methods of manuring in oil palm. Usually found in estates are manually manuring, means using the workforce. Each worker has stated how many gunnies of fertilizer must finish and how many plants to be covered. But big company nowadays use the technology, which is the using of machineries. This can make the manuring practices easier. Just setting the amount, distance and method of scatter on the machineries. Manuring usually started at the end of the first quarter of year with 3 or 4 times per year. Fertilizer application must be done with the moderate rain season. As we know, oil palm is one of the plant that need high amount of water. So, at the estates, we can see the estates dig a border ditch and many small ditches at the oil palm block, or stated by the company how many ditches per hectare. This is to make sure that oil palm get enough water for their growth. Oil palm need 120 until 150 millimeter of water every month. Oil palm also need pest and disease control. For pest, we can separate it into 2 parts, which is animal and weed. For weed control in oil palm, estates commonly use chemical control for instant result. Commercial oil palm commonly use gallon, which is the active ingredient is triclopyl, Roundup, glyphosate and Kenpo. These 3 ingredients we mix into mist blower and also mix with water. This mixture must follow the ratio needed or follow the instruction at the label, but usually estates create their own ratio according to the size of land and the amount of plant that need to be covered. If we follow the instruction at the label, it is for the small size ratio of land and small land need to be covered. For the animal pest control, there are a few types of pests. First, rhinoceros beetle, oil palm weevil, apogonia beetle, jaffer beetle, nettle caterpillar, oil palm bagworm, and termites. There is all called insect pests. For non-insect pests, there are rats, elephants, monkey, squirrels, and wild boar. To control the insect pests, there are a few methods which commonly used: chemical control, trunk injection, sanitation, planting beneficial plant, and growth the natural enemies for the insect. For the non-insect pests, also have their ways to control, such as establish barn oil, 1 barn per 10 hectares, and apply electronic fence and put trapping. For disease control, there are 3 stages of disease, which is field disease, nursery disease, and seed disease. But we focus on field disease. Common disease found in estates are basal stem rots, fruit bunch rot, fruit rot, and marasmus bunch rot. To control basal stem rot, first is safeguard control. Upgrade the oil palm normal guards. For example, through lignin control was recommended by numerous examinations announced that copper and calcium supplementations could be utilized to decrease the seriousness of the basal stem decay in oil palm at the seedling stage. Corruption of lignin by compounds delivered by Ganoderma might be hindered by control of temperature, pH and water circulations, high carbon and high nitrogen and halides, metal chelators, weighty metals and lessening specialists. Next, use chemical control. Attempt to control basal stem root in the lab and field by the utilization of foundational fungicide, example triadimethoxan, carboxin, carbendazim, mesfurozem, have been accounted for. Anyway, of the sequences of this investigation was all uncertain, albeit some foundational fungicide and some fumigants is by all account promising. Synthetic control by infusion with a fungicide, for example triazole and hexaconazole, was accounted for to diminish Ganoderma azote. This examination expressed that solid developed palm treated with hexaconazole applied through soil infusion and soil drenching gave altogether lower rates palm with basal stem root accurate. Lastly, control basal stem root with biological control. Conceivable control of Ganoderma utilizing common adversaries has been read for a long time by numerous researchers. This technique has acquired a lot of consideration in the past decades as a method of lessening the utilization of substance in terms of horticulture. That's all from me. Thank you.